truth of who you are. You are a son. You are loved. The Lord has a plan. The Lord says you're a masterpiece. You're an heir. You're not a slave. You're not a loser. You're not one who's just a mind thing. For you, everything is mental. For you, everything's intellectual. For you, everything, if it doesn't make sense in my head, then it's not real. The Lord's about to shock you. The Lord's about to release some things that are beyond your understanding. And then you'll see the hand of the Lord in a supernatural way that will cause you to reflect again how you process things. There's a teacher in you. There's an instructor in you. There's one that will train others. There's one who will release. God's about to change even the desires and the wantings of your heart, even the things that lead you, even the things, the appetites that draw you away and not towards the Lord. He's about to make a shift. If you cooperate with him, you will be amazed what he'll do 3 months from now. You'll be shocked in the places you will be. He sees in the night. He sees in the dark. He knows who you are. He knows the buttons that are triggered. He knows the things that are there. Respond to him in his wooing and come to the Spirit of grace, and you watch how he will remove even the stains and remove even the places where you go for where you find peace in, and he'll give you real peace, real grace, and real freedom even from yourself. Sometimes you're your worst enemy, you know? And God just like almost you sabotage yourself. But God is about to restructure even the way, because you won't look at yourself the way these words that hit you are anymore, to be able to say, God, you wire me differently. If this man, if this word is true, then here I am, God. Change the way I see myself. Change the way I see others. Change the way I see you, and let me receive what I need to move forward to the places where I need to go in Jesus' name. I see the grace of God creativity. He wants to bring joy. He wants to release something, but like pull you out from muddy. Like I see mud on your legs and your shoes, like you were stuck somewhere and you were not able to go. I see the Lord bringing you out of these places where you've been stuck in, where your emotions have been locked in and you have not been able to really express that, which actually you're a very expressive person when you're not around. When you're free and you're not in other places, you can really move and you can really express, and the things popping in your heart, the Lord's going to cause a deliverance of the fear of ridicule and the fear of disappointing and the fear of not being what the expectations are on you. God's about to go like take you out of this place and cause the waters of the word to just wash you and cleanse you, to be able to just be in a place where you by the river, Psalm 1, that your roots are by the river and your tree is full of good fruit and the leaf doesn't wither and whatever you set your hand to do will prosper. There's an anointing for prosperity in your life. There's an anointing for the creative power. There's construction. There's a building grace upon your life. There's a designing grace upon your life that you're able to see from above and be able to see things that others are able to build, and you're even yourself will be able to build even in situations. God's going to give you this eye, going to give you a release of creativity, but you'll come out from the mud, come out from this place you've been stuck in. Take a walk unto the Lord and you watch what he will do as you obey him in the simple things he's asked you to do. So Father, I pray that you seal this word in him in the name of Jesus. The grace will be upon you too in a whole different way. You're about to pray in a whole different way. You're about to enter into a grace, not just for your own life, but even for your family. You're going to be able to motivate, not out of fear, but out of love in a whole different dimension. You're going to be able to motivate a release of something that is true here, it's true everywhere. Like the Lord is going to cause you to be an honest witness everywhere you go. There will be a grace and a power of God to be able to make you the very things you're praying for. He's about to answer the very prayers that you're praying concerning you. It's not about others. It's concerning you. You as the epicenter, as the shaper of the culture, even of your own home and even in the places that you go, the Lord is going to shift something on the inside where a different aroma and a different grace is going to come out from you, and it won't be a religious thing, and it won't be a legal thing, and it won't be a principle thing, but it will be a love thing. It will be a grace thing. It will be a release of trust unto God that you cannot keep in the little circle, a control form, but you're going to have to tear that umbrella and turn it into a funnel and allow the Lord to release even unto your family and even to those around you the grace of God, so you're able to leave from a different place and even pray and even see yourself from a different place. The Lord's hand will be upon your life. He's about to he's about to close off a stream in order for you to receive another. He's gonna like dams in a river. He's gonna lock off some waters of influence even in your life, so you're able to partake of different waters that are gonna water a different seed that's gonna be planted in your heart. Wow. And I see the Lord doing causing contradictions in your mind, where you're gonna have to do even as my wife's word was today, to reset and start over, not get rid of foundations, but truly the way that you're motivated and the way you've motivated yourself. Because you have to rise up, and people don't get that sometimes. You have to move when people didn't believe in you, when people didn't have your back, and you have to move forward when nobody else was wanting to move with you. And sometimes you feel people have been so ungrateful and you've been so unfairly treated. But the Lord made you tough for a reason. The Lord caused His love to come into your heart, so you're able then to minister to others and sympathize with others in the others' journeys that have been tough, so that you don't lay on them guilt or lay on them the thing, I did this and therefore you need to do it. But you can come under and says, I'll help you up now. I'll lift you up now. I don't have to motivate you by what happened to me. I motivate you by what the Lord has already done. A shift of paradigm from above to below is about to take place, and a grace in your lips, like salt restored on your lips, that will release medicine to your bones in your family, at your workplace, even in the church realm and in the ministry that the Lord has given you. A different word will come forth from you. A son of encouragement will go forth like a Barnabas, and a grace of God to lift up rather than to push down, come forth from you. But He's going to do it in you. So He's going to remove even revelation that you had about how the Father treated you. The Lord is going to open up a whole different bouquet of flowers, and a different smell in the garden will come forth. And you'll see, oh my God, I missed this from you. And then you will never be the same as a result of that which will connect to you. Get ready for some serious surgery. Get in your heart. Get ready for an encounter with the living God. The Lord's grace will be upon you. You will not weep. You will laugh. You will not be full of sorrow. You will rise up. You will be one who will be protected, and you will be one who will be free from ill conceptions and misconceptions of what it is to be a woman in the kingdom. The Lord will release grace. The Lord will release a different model. You will not be controlling as a result of fear. You will not be speaking as a result of things that happened in the past. You will be able to trust and entrust and empower both your children and others to be able to be all that they can be without speaking consistently about things that took place in the past. God's surgery is at hand. The whole family is undergoing a real release. I just see a real grace, a real healing, a real reconstruction in your heart, a real freedom that the Lord has for you, a real design for life, a design for blessing upon you, a real restoration of self-worth, a real restoration of true identity as King's kids. The Lord is about to kiss your heart, and I pray in the name of Jesus for your grace to be sufficient in them. them, even in this time and even in this hour, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Gotta pick up.
There's a combination, there's a cultivation of this fruit in your life where you are again trusting your life like you trusted in Jesus. Hope against hope. You believe. You believe when your family didn't work. You believe when it was dangerous. You believe when things were not going the way you thought, and yet you believe. Is it not the same faith not to believe even for that which is going on in your life? If he did the little and he did the much, will he not continue to do and do and do that which he promised to do? I tell you, do not fret anymore. Do not worry anymore. You can't add. You're taking life out of yourself. You're hurting yourself by all of this because it doesn't help you one bit to do that which you do. Release it to God and don't think that what you do is what makes things happen. You are to give it to the Lord, believe and trust in Him, and not allow the anxiety to so grip you that it would paralyze you in the walking out of this situation. Your grandkids and your kids will be up in the hands of God. You release them and you shift the way you speak to the Lord concerning them, and you watch how the fire of heaven will intercept even their very desires and back them into corners that you cannot rescue them out of. And you cannot speak into it, but you can declare over them the goodness of God and the grace of God and the power of God to bring forth the great salvation of the King even upon their lives. Spirit of God's going to come on you now. He's going to give you different words and eyes to see. He's sneaking around. The Lord sees all things. The Lord's going to give you an eyes to see and ears to hear only that which God will whisper in your heart. Just because you can doesn't mean you should. Just because you can get away and nobody sees, you're never really alone. The Lord sees. God's grace is going to come. A spirit of wow. It's like somebody, you're going to sense somebody in the room. You're going to feel the hand of God even on you. Even when you're away, even from home and even from school, you will feel a hand on your shoulder. Your big brother is going to have your back. You're going to be able to sense something very unique, begin to have it, an awareness of the presence of God even in your age. You need to begin to talk to Him. You need to begin to whisper, look, Jesus, if this is real, I want to know you. And it's not a religious thing anymore. God's going to say, open up your mouth and talk to me. I want to have a conversation. You're going to feel the hand of the Lord. He's going to whisper to you in dreams. He's already visited you in the nighttime. He's spoken to your heart before, and you know, man, that couldn't have come from me, and that was not my grandma or my parents. A voice is speaking to me. He's going to make it clear. He's going to develop communication and establish it with you. Respond to Him, even at your age. Say, here I am, Lord. Here I am. Speak to me in a way that I can understand. And you watch and see how things will begin to move at a whole different realm. You'll begin to see things, even from you. You'll begin to have pictures. You'll begin to have visions. You'll begin to see situations in a whole different realm. You'll begin to have answers to problems. problems, not just your stuff, but somebody else's stuff. And God's going to give you courage to open up your mouth and be able to declare even to your friends that which is going on, and you say it in a non-religious way. Hey, look, man, I think this, this, and that. And they'll be blown away by the things that will come forth from your mouth. This is a time for you to actually hear and actually do that which you see modeled even in the presence of the Lord, because God will develop a language that you will understand is you and Him connected, and as a result, you'll be able to flow into places and even at a young age begin to open a wide a river that's going to flow into a whole different dimension. I know you probably don't get at all what I'm trying to say, but do this one thing: seek the Lord. Psalm 27, so that you would behold them, the beauty of the Lord, to meditate in His house of the Lord all the days of your life, so that your head would be lifted above your enemies, and you'll be able to carry out the plan of God upon your life. Woo! Jesus, I pray, grandma and grandson, papa and mama in the background, I just pray for the grace of God to be abundant. And I ask you, Holy Spirit, to move him in a whole different dimension. Seal this word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay. I can do that. That's why you make some decisions. You ready to change? Father, I pray that in the name of Jesus, I break the yoke of the bondage up on him. I break the yoke of the past and the addiction, in the name of Jesus. Just the self-interest and just all the need. Yeah. making choices for himself, right? Making choices for yourself, right? So your parents can't make that choice for you. You better make it yourself. So I release you from the anxiety of it. I release you from the anxiety of having to make choices. You get home and do position him for him to make the best choice. Just bless and not curse. Release grace. This is mother's prerogative. Always that way. He's a good man stuck in a situation, but the Lord's gonna pull him up, and there's nothing you can do about it at this point except pray, believe, and rest. We know the decision to be able to be on. He knows the Lord, right? Yeah. You know, there's nothing in your information that you're able to do. And all God's about to bring him to places where he can.